If you go to the NCBI website or Flybase or one of the many repositories of genomic information, if you go to them and you ask them for a piece of DNA, they give you something that looks like this. This particular example is the third chromosome, like 11,300,000, somewhere around that, somewhere in the middle of this particular chromosome. They give you a list of bases. The bases in this case are, let's just go for it and write them out. G, C, C, T, G, C, G, G, C, A. Of course, the nature of DNA is that if you have one strand, you know what the other strand looks like. So let's go ahead and add the other strand. Let's do it in red. So G gives you C, C gives you G, C gives you G, A, T gives you A, G gives you C. The formality of the way this is handled is that DNA is always double-stranded, but they give you one strand. The formality is that they give you the 5' end, so that the strand they've given you is the 5' end. And if this is the 5' end, then this particular piece becomes the codon. So this becomes the codon. The transcription factor finds the DNA and says, okay, this is the codon. The RNA polymerase comes in, and the RNA polymerase makes a piece of RNA against the anticodon, so that the anticodon specifies the codon, which is the piece that we're looking at. But there's a 50% probability, mathematically exactly 50% probability, that the codon is actually on the other strand. So let's look at it down on this side just a little bit. If the codon is on the other strand, the transcription factor found the spot it wants to start at, but now the codon is on this side. The DNA polymerase melts the DNA. The DNA polymerase reads the anticodon and puts the messenger RNA against the anticodon, and the codon is now on the other strand. So that this is, and of course this is still the 5' end. So against the 5' end, this is the codon. Against the 5' end, this is the codon. And there's a 50-50 chance that it could be one or the other. When they do shotgun genomic sequencing, they cut the DNA up in various pieces, which overlap. They sequence those pieces and then feed everything into a series of computer programs, and the computer programs sort everything out and tell you what the original strand was. The programs have to be written to accommodate the fact that they're not sure which end they're looking at.